is where you get off, and then this is where you catch the bus again.
Morning, guys. How are you?
Good.
Oh, how you doing, man?
Our area is responsible for purchasing and maintaining all of Calgary Transit's buses, trains, and auxiliary vehicles. So this facility was built in 2009. It is named after Mr. Oliver Bowen, who is was responsible.
If to track parts and labor, we coordinate what trains are coming in the building, what trains are going out. So we use these monitors up here to help us with red lines are indicating the power in the shop and in the yards, and anything that is green has the power's been turned off so we can work on the trains or whatever. So in the building we can control the power in the shop and in the barn. Out in the yard, that's controlled from rail control and NMAX. We have no control over shutting it off or turning it back on. So the next series of boards are like running repair type things like light bulbs or whatever we can do in the barn, but we restrict most of and all of the work to the shop, only like minor like windshield wipers or light bulbs or something we can work in the barn. So really 8 trains at any one time, and then the odd, you know, running repair or something in the barn.
The train, like a door is broken or something to the effect, they'll phone us and we'll add it to this defect board. So then from here, we'll generate a work order, we'll bring that train into the shop for a repair or diagnosis or whatever, and then it gets taken off the board. So my job would be, among other things, is to control the stuff on the board. So this is basically just a spreadsheet that we make a web page for. So this is a web page.
At the end of the day, operator, when they park the car, they'll pour the pantograph. And the electric motor works against that spring tension to bring it down. Thanks, buddy. So just make on your old cars, they vary. When they have these things tested and when they're running them,
it is.
So basically, it's between the tire and the wheel. So it compresses from about there to, say, 30% compression. And you can actually, once it's in between the two, it's actually just, you see that much in there. So it goes from 3,600 foot going. The trailer doesn't wear quite as much. So.
Chelsea, we go up on the wash line, and these are the passenger doors in Calgary. I think they do have a
similar
state. They've also should be divided.
It's not that bad, but most of the time, yes.
Most things for sure.
Yeah.
That's called the clang
car of the
big loud.
He's got to
that's, My because they're super trained.
The old trains are just not going to help.
I see the one downtown.
You may regret showing him those buttons.
You're halfway to the end of the terminal already. You can already drive down 7th Avenue.
Stop honking it, it's so loud. Sometimes you see like go flames go or